Pastor Brian Lee. And our first question from our media guest is, what else should the Philippines look forward to from Taitra or Taiwan beyond your Song of Excellence in deepening partnerships with Taiwan and Philippines?
So, thank you for your interest beyond your Song of Excellence, legacy context. Taitra is a trade and investment promotion organization, and it is our focus to promote bilateral trade and economic relations with the other countries, and especially with the Philippines. And for this year, we have conducted several projects, such as Go Green with Taiwan. We invite proposals from the Philippines to use Taiwan green products and green solutions to solve environmental issues and for sustainability. And the award is $20,000.
Yeah. Wow. Taiwan.
And we also organize digital campaign. It's called One Good Habit, Love the Earth. You know, to form a good habit, it takes 21 days. So if you have a good habit, that's good for the environment. And we encourage that habit to form, to be formed. And we also have this digital campaign all over the world. And we send trade missions to also the Philippines, covering smart cities and cold chains, as well as ICT products. And next year, I'll be happy to announce, we are going to organize a solo show. It's called Taiwan Expo in Philippines. We would like to expand our relations with the Philippines. And it's also my wish, next year, your Song of Excellence will be even stronger, and we'll have more people participating, and we have great judges, and a great host. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much. Question from our media friends. This one is from Ron Ryan Hugis from the Manila Times. And the question is for also Mr. Brian Lee to answer. Oh, he's here. Okay. Would you like to ask a question?
Okay. I'll ask.
All right. So our broad team will be going around the audience for our media partners to be able to ask and extend their questions for Mr. Brian Lee.
Could you share where consumers from the Philippines can currently purchase Taiwan Excellence products?
Okay, yeah, that's an important point. You know, Taiwan Excellence awarded the product. It's a product recognized by Taiwan, and it's of good quality and with innovation and sustainability. So now in Philippines, you can buy Taiwan Excellence awarded products. Firstly, through the official retailer PC Express. They have shops in major shopping malls, and offline and online. And additionally, you can buy those products through official websites of those brand companies. And in this event, already we have invited 12 brand companies. They set up their booth there, and you will be able to contact them directly and ask for the procurement option.
Thank you very much for your question, and thank you very much, Mr. Brian Lee. We have another question for you, sir. This one is from Ann Torres of the Philippine Daily Inquirer. So I believe Ms. Ann is here to ask the question. There she is. Thank you very much.
Hello, good afternoon. Good evening. Okay, my question is, what else should the Philippines look forward to from Taira or Taiwan beyond your Song of Excellence in deepening the partnership with the Philippines? Okay, what do we need to look forward for after the Song of Excellence?
I saw this question, I just answered about we will be sending more trade missions. And I would like to say that we are going to promote also Taiwanese food to the Philippine market. And we also actually invite Philippines food importer distributor to Taiwan. You know? So in the future you will have you can see not only Chinese food but also Taiwanese food. Okay?
Can I ask one more question? I don't know if anybody can answer, maybe from the judges. Is it okay? Okay. Can you tell us, can you share the journey of this second Song of Excellence? Because before it was only, single lang yun eh. Not right now, it's a dual legacy. So how can you share us your journey with regards to how the process of the competition, so what are the expectations and ano yung nagulat kayo from this competition?
Okay, so thank you so much for your question. Siguro ang kakaiba nito from the past, no, kasi this is only my second time to judge. And like si Yeng, this is your third na. So, hindi ko alam yung naabutan ni Yeng, but at least sa journey ko with your Song of Excellence, yung naabutan ko parang singer-songwriter to, din ito, pero hindi sila magkasama. Kumbaga, may sariling competition si singer, meron din si songwriter, tapos within the show, dun lang sila pagsasamahin. Ito, I think it's much more challenging kasi para sa artist, no, for me, na talaga kailangan balansin mo silang ma-judge. Eh. Kasi merong iba magaling kumanta, pero yung sa songwriting, parang it can be improved or vice versa naman. So talagang mas nahirapan kami na judges, or at least ako, kasi parang kailangan mahanap ko yung balance ng magaling sila magsulat, pero yung katanda nila, magaling din kumanta. So medyo challenging, but it's a good journey for all of us.
Would anyone else like to take a crack at that question?
Ako yung pinakabago kasi. So, I'm the newest member. My first time ko rin to judge a competition like this na sa akin ni Ice, the singer, the songwriter. And ako, galing din ako sa banda. Parang there should be that certain chemistry that you cannot fake. You know, it's not easy to come up with something excellent. Excellence is something it's kumbaga, may kasama siyang X factor, may kasama charm, may kasama talent, yung story that you want to tell. No? So parang, it's very challenging, pero I think yun yung fun part nitong ginagawa namin kasi we get to experience din yung process nila or maging part ka din ng process nila as yung ganung klase na duo kasi hindi madali to like just sit down with another person and say, oh, okay, sige, let's do something excellent, diba? So, ano yun, parang may magic, isa siya magic, parang you don't really know what's gonna happen next, so
that
makes it really fun, really
exciting.
Thank you, Kia.
Well said, Kia. Well, I think there's also a balance, no? There's also there's certain themes with regards to a singer, songwriter, but sometimes they're both songwriters and singers. So it's a teamwork, it's a balance of both. Like, for instance, someone would compose the lyrics and the other person would do the melody. In hindsight, they're a team. So there's a balance between the two. It doesn't matter if like the person is a singer or this, and the other one's a songwriter. So it could be a balance of the two. We've discovered also that some of the songwriters also were singers or are singers. So there's a balance in that. But they also perform at the same time during the eliminations. It's a good balance. So it's teamwork talaga. That we found na parang also the time pressure given, like we were giving them a certain amount of like days for them to come up with a song, then perform it, no? Then especially during the finals, I think they were only given 2 days, like 1 day for the core value song, then the other for the Taiwan Excellent Song that they're supposed to be close. So that's a really huge challenge. Because for normal songwriters, it's not that easy composing a song right then and there, and you have to compete with it, you know, the other song singer also performing it in that much, the time frame that's given. So it's a huge challenge for them.
Thank you for sharing that, Mr. Paulo Zarate. do we have any, perhaps, okay, well, our floor is still open to our media friends for any questions.
Hello, good afternoon. I'm John Boyner from Comico.com. I'm a vlogger. Well, I'd like to put my question to the judges. Of course, nakita naman natin na yung mga contestants per se, they are very talented. And 11,000 entries, how were you able to like put in like only a few people? How were you able to choose? And siguro kasama na dun yung next factor na sinasabi Ian earlier. Was it an impossible thing to do? Any of the judges?
Sa experience ko po nung binigay po sa amin yung pagpipilian ng mga contestants. It was really hard. I think pinakinggan ko po yung bawat kanta 3 times. Oh. Bawat kanta. Tapos binalikan ko ulit, nakapag-desisyon na ako na these are the ones na pakiramdam ko okay to enter the competition. Nakinig ko po ulit. Nasa car, tapos nakasettle daw na ako sa bahay. Just to make sure, kasi sobrang dami po talagang magagaling na songwriters ng Pilipinas. And I would also like to take this opportunity to thank Taiwan Excellence for giving platform to Filipino talents. Maraming salamat po. We have so much time, so you can just imagine how hard it was for us. Really.
Meron ba sa inyong medyo na-disappoint sa choice na, of course, you're a group na you had to cut down people from the list. May na-disappoint ba na hindi nakuha yung certain contestant or certain songwriter?
I think it's safe to say na for this year, parang halos pare-pareho tayo ng mga naging choices. Which is good kasi para kami ng mga, parang for us, hindi dapat talaga muna makapasok, kailangan pa na improvement. Pero halos pareho din kami sa mga pinili namin na, these guys are good. Alam mo yun? So nakakatuwa lang because like with Yang and Kuya Pao, it's our second time to be part of the judging panel. And of course, Ian is also a good friend. Talagang kahit kami judges mismo, we also have a certain parang chemistry na rin going on. Parang may mga iba-iba rin ang tinitignan. Like si Yang, she focuses talaga sa songwriting. Alam mo yun, grabe siya. Ako feeling ko mas nag-focus naman ako sa singing side of things. So, it's a good balance. Si Kian, hindi ko alam kung anong focus niya, ano. Pero hayaan na natin. I'm sure meron naman. But may Kuya Pao, of course, the overall everything, no? So, it's a good balance of judges also. We have our own expertise and that we can put on the table. Yeah.
Boss
Kian,
saan ka
nag-concentrate? Sabi nga niya, hindi mo lang ma-focus, hindi ko nag-concentrate. Ano kasi, totoo yung sinasabi ni Aris eh, parang yung chemistry kasi ito, yung music, it's para for me the hardest thing to judge din. Because yung music ay, parang yun yung power din ng music eh, di ba, na hindi walang best, di ba, pero may maganda. I mean, may solid. Ako kasi, I don't believe na merong pangit na song. Walang pangit na song, walang pangit na ano. It's just that we have different preferences and taste. And ano, so yun pa lang, medyo hindi na siya like easy task. Dahil kailangan mo rin manggaling sa, like, kung ano, iba rin yung mood mo for the day or yung sa certain time na yun. Pero, kailangan mong mapili yung tingin mo at tingin nyo bilang judges na ito yung para sa atin yung malulubid dito sa or naniniwala tayo enough na kaya nilang pumasok dito sa ganito klase ng competition. Academy. So, ayun na naman, but I mean, the whole process was fun, di ba? Ano ko, super dami nagpasa ng entries, and salamat sa lahat ng tao behind this project, because, I mean, we can put already 11,000. Ano siya, teamwork din talaga siya, parang gano'n. So, yeah, masaya siya. Ano yung music ko pinag-uusapan natin, sabi na si Brian, parang, it's all about love and music, diba, na kung nakasubito. So,
thank you very much, Kia. And thank you very much for your question. I believe we have room for one last question from our media friends. All right, good
afternoon. My question is just an iteration. What are you looking for when you choose to be leaders?
Yes, that's a good question. Well, yeah, judging them, we probably judge them through the criteria. But personally, I'm looking for someone, you know, to add value to the art industry. Because knowing the Filipinos, that we're all talented. And I'm happy to see we are thriving new composers in the Philippines. Now, I think this is one of the great values na inanong contest nito. We have great composers. Na nabibigyan palagi ng platform to have their songs be heard. I think marrying of the both the performer and the composer, the storytelling behind it. And ang maganda kasi sa contest ito, there's no, it's not genre specific. Any genre can join, and I think it's just, you know, the connection siguro, relaying the message of the song. And probably I could see is ano relevant sila sa pagpasok sa music industry. Would they add value to our music industry? But it's like, because you know, we are a culture that influenced by other, you know, K-pop, J-pop, rock, American rock, we've got British pop rock, you know, halo-halo. So ngayon, natutuwa ka na may flavor na lumalabas from the Philippines. Like we've got this SB19, Bini, other band groups like Benedict, other rock groups also coming out. So I'm happy that the music industry now in the Philippines is thriving. At sana tuloy-tuloy pa rin ang pag-ano ng music industry in the Philippines. Yun lang.
Mas siguro ang hinahanap ko, kagaya rin sinabi ni Kuya Paulos, yung connection, no? Kasi marami nga magaling sumulat, marami magaling kumanta. Pero para sa akin, for that song to connect to me as an audience, that's very important then, because that's only when it becomes life-changing. So, yun yun.
Ako po, parang medyo pareho po kami nagsagot ni Ice, no? Kasi po yung sa technical part, nagawa na po yung sa production eh, yung pagsinsin ng pagsulat ng letra ng kanta, yung melody na gusto mong takbuhan ng song, yung technique na gagawin, pinractice mo na yan eh. Pero yung ganito po sa pagpiti show, yung actual po ng may audience, paano kaparating ng mga finalists natin, yung energy na yun, yung whether it be joy or sadness that they were inspired to write, paano po mararamdaman ang audience? Paano namin mararamdaman ng mga judges? Yung po yung parang magic na sinasabi ko yung cake, it's magical. That magic moment, that's what I'm really looking for. And I would also like to comment, Taiwan Excel, kinlato ko lang po ito kay Directors kanina. After po this competition, the songs, they still own their songs. So they can do whatever they want. Hindi po na inumano, but hindi po siya aakinin ng Taiwan Excellence. They can do whatever they want. What I want excellence in one video is mas ma-inspire po yung mga artists na ito mas na, you got the taste na of what it feels like to perform sa ganitong klaseng stage, to be seen online by your audience, ganyan. Sana maituloy nila. And hindi po yung parang na-type pa rin kayo sa amin, whatever you do, na parang nakaano kayo, parang nakatulong. And that kind of mentality and heart, grabe po yun, sobrang yung pinakad na value nila sa mga talento Pilipino. So gusto ko lang po ulit na palakpakan sila for that. So thank you so much.
Pero, hindi, siguro songwriting talaga. Yun lang talaga yung parang pinaka-pinagpapasihan na ano niya, nahanapin. Yun niya, walang genre na nagsasarado ng boxes. Parang, ano yung nag-hit kami sa, lalo na, kami rin, mga songwriters kami, so parang, alam mo yun eh, pag kumama sa iyo yung kanta, di ba? Whether novelty yan, o rock yan, or ballad, or whatever, di ba? Basta, it's all about, ano, parang hitting that right spot sa soul. So, songwriting talaga. Eh, ang gagaling yung sulat ng mga, ano, na mga narinig namin. Kaya ako, refreshing dahil lalo tayo, Pinoy, di ba? Hindi natin na kumanta eh. So, madalas tayo nakita ng mga singing contest. Yeah, but it's refreshing to have a project like this. Kind of songwriting, champion yung composers. Di ba? Yeah.
Thank you. Very meaningful.